In a previous video, we've seen how to make this block acquire smart capabilities and thus be able to stretch the sides through grips to lengthen the wall and the fence at the same time. In this video, we will learn how to use the visibility parameter in order to change between the six types of doors that can be seen here. The drawing that we have above is a custom block, while the ones that appear here below are drawings that combine arcs, lines, and polylines. The first thing we will do is to incorporate the drawings of the doors inside the custom block. For this, we select all the doors, and with the key combination Ctrl plus X, we're going to cut them. Now we double click on the custom block to edit it, then use the key combination Ctrl plus V to paste the doors inside. In this case, we are going to create an element of visibility and place it with a click. We see that the panel containing the visibility states is enabled, and we click on visibility state. Since there are six doors, we need six visibility states. We can assign them a name or accept the one that comes by default and change it later. Now pay attention to these three icons. Basically, we have to go state by state and define what geometry is going to be seen and what is not. For example, in the first state of visibility, we want to see the indicated door and not the rest. For this, we use the icon on the right to hide the unwanted doors. We change to the next state, and we will hide all of them, except the first one in the bottom row. We change to the next state of visibility to repeat the same action, and thus configure each of the doors. All in all, this icon helps us to hide geometry in a certain state of visibility. Once the visibility states are configured, although the doors should be moved to their final position, it is convenient to first test the block. That's why we close, save the changes, and test it. We select the block, we click on the grip, and we test the visibility states one by one. In the third option, we detect an error, since one more door appears. We continue testing the rest. At the moment, only the third option has an error, which we will correct by editing the block again. We switch to the third state of visibility and hide the unwanted door. We close and save the changes to corroborate that the custom block is already corrected. Now we can edit the block to activate all the doors using the first of the three icons that appear in the display state section to be able to visualize all the elements turned off or not. And then we can move each of the doors to its final position. For this, we will use the move command. We close and save the changes in the custom block to now try again the different states of visibility. In any case, the states of visibility can have a proper name, which we'll be able to easily modify. This will help to be able to choose more easily the type of door selected. Eventually, one could name each door after its reference from the manufacturer. In the first video, we've seen how to add grips to lengthen the wall. At the same time, we increase the vertical elements of the fence. In this video, we've seen how to use visibility states to vary the design of the door of this access, according to different pre-configured options. In the next video, we're going to combine the two concepts, so that when changing for a specific type of door, the type of fence is also changed, while this is adapted to the length of the wall. So I create an even more powerful block. To learn more about custom blocks in ARES Commander, be sure to visit the extensive help offered by the software.